The overall process for creating and managing report packages is fundamentally the same for Word, PowerPoint, and PDF-based report packages. The focus of this tutorial is the key differences in PDF-based report packages, merging doclets into a PDF report package, defining headers and footers, adding PDF, Word, and Excel doclets, adding report doclets, and adding a table of contents. Let's begin by creating a report package. Provide a name and an optional description. For Word and PowerPoint report packages, you must upload a style sample. When you select PDF as the report type, style sample is automatically set to headers and footers. On the General tab of the Headers and Footers dialog, you can define a common header and footer to be applied to all the PDF pages within the report, or you can define different headers and footers for even and odd pages. You can define the starting page number, select the doclet where you want to begin stamping, and select any doclets you want to exclude from stamping. We'll return to this tab later in the tutorial after we have added doclets. For now, I'll select the All Pages tab, add a header, and format the text. I'll also add a footer and page numbering. When I'm done editing headers and footers, I click OK and browse to the location where I want to save my report package. When you click Next, notice that the steps are the same as those for a Word or PowerPoint-based report package. You can define the process by enabling phases, assign users, define options, and then select Finish to open the report package. Let's add a PDF doclet. I'll name the doclet and provide an optional description, set type to PDF, and browse to select a PDF file. I'll save this PDF doclet and add another. Now let's add a report to the report package. This time I set type to report, browse to the library, and select a report. If you click Yes, the service will create a persistent link to the document file. For this example, I'll click No. Similar to adding reports in Word and PowerPoint report packages, you have the option to modify the POV and select variables. Now let's add a Word doclet. The key difference here is you do not need to select a style sample as you do in a Word-based report package. Browse to select a Word file. The system converts the Word document to PDF and merges it into the report package. Let's add an Excel doclet. You can choose which worksheets to include in the report package. I'll leave All Worksheets Included selected. The system converts each worksheet to PDF and then merges the worksheets into the report package. Finally, let's add a table of contents. I'll select Table of Content Doclet and browse to a Word document without an automatic table of contents to see the results. I receive a validation error warning that the document does not have an automatic table of contents. This time, I'll select a Word document with an automatic table of contents. I'll save the report package and move the table of contents below the cover page. If I preview the table of contents by itself, notice that the page numbers are not generated and links are not active. However, if I preview the entire report package, the system automatically updates the table of contents based on the report package structure and generates a PDF file for the table of contents doclet with page numbers and active links. If you edit the report package and return to headers and footers, you now have the option to select the doclet to start stamping and select doclets to exclude from stamping. Let's preview the report package to confirm the changes. Notice there is no stamping on the cover page. Stamping begins on the Table of Contents page. Headers, footers, and page numbers are displayed as expected. Reports and Word and Excel documents have been converted to PDF and merged into the report package. To learn more, visit docs.com. www.oracle.com.